Let's talk some about vector addition and subtraction. So first, a little bit of motivation. So let's say this is you, the little stick person in my picture, and you want to swim across a river. And we're going to use vectors to think about it. So let's say you're swimming straight. Okay, so I'm going to draw a vector to represent that motion. Okay, so here is the motion, or the vector that represents your swimming, right? So it has a magnitude, which would be the speed you're swimming at, and it has a direction. So you're trying to go just straight across the river. And I'm just going to label this V sub S, the vector that represents your swimming. Now, but let's say the river has a current. Okay, so let's say the river has a current, a downstream current that's just straight downstream. So I'm also going to draw a vector to represent that. And let's say it's not too strong of a current. So I'm going to represent that by having this vector have a smaller magnitude than the swimming vector I drew. And I'm going to label this V sub C, okay, so the vector that represents the current. Okay, so now intuitively, which direction are you going to move? Well, because the current is pulling you a little bit, you're not going to be moving just straight across the stream. Instead, you're going to have a little bit of a drift to your movement. So, and I'm not going to draw this exactly, but you know, something in this general direction is going to be the resulting vector of your movement. Okay, and what we're actually doing there is adding these two vectors. Okay, so this vector I just drew is the swimming vector plus the current vector. Okay, so hopefully that gives you an intuitive sense for what we're going to do. So what I'm going to do next is show you how to add vectors geometrically and subtract as well. And then a little later on in the lesson, we'll actually learn how to do it algebraically. All right, so I'm actually going to show you two different geometric methods of adding vectors. So in this picture here, I have two vectors pictured, vectors U and vector V. Okay, and what I'm going to show you now is called the triangle rule. Okay, and what we want to do is we want to draw the vector U plus V. That's my goal. Okay, so this is how it's going to work in the triangle rule. So remember, a vector is defined by its magnitude and direction, so I can move these around and they're still the same vector, all right, as long as they're pointing in the same direction. So what you're going to do in the triangle rule, okay, you have your first vector, which for me is U. Now I'm going to take my second vector, V, and I'm going to put the tail of V at the head of U, just like that. Okay, so U, and then at the head of U, I put the tail of V. Okay, and then the vector U plus V, to draw that, I'm simply going to connect the tail here of U to the head of V. So if I do that, it's going to look like this. Okay, so this is the sum of the vectors. So the vector I just drew is the vector U plus V. Now it doesn't matter which order you do this in, right? So I could have considered V my first vector and then put the tail of U on the head of V, and it would have got the same thing. It'd be in a different position, but it'd be the same vector. Okay, so this is the triangle rule. Okay, and now I'm going to show you the next method for doing this. Now this one is called the parallelogram rule. If I can spell it. All right. Parallelogram. Well, close enough for math, right? Parallelogram rule. Now, once again, my goal is still just to actually draw the vector U plus V. And I'm going to kind of start in a similar way. I have my two vectors, vector U and vector V, and once again, the position doesn't matter. I can move the position and they'll still be the same vector. So that's what I'm going to do. And of course, if you're doing this on paper, you couldn't actually drag them. You just have to redraw them. Now this time what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the two vectors in a tail-to-tail position like this. Okay, so their tails are meeting. Okay, and then I'm going to make, I'm going to complete a parallelogram, or what I have so far are two sides of that parallelogram. Okay, so let's start with vector V. Okay, basically I just want to kind of copy that vector and make it this opposite side of the parallelogram. And then same with vector U, so that I form a parallelogram with these vectors. So then the vector U plus V, if I draw that in, is going to go from this tail-tail corner to this head-head corner like this. And you can see that this looks very similar to what we had before. It should look exactly the same. The position might be slightly different, but it's the same vector. It has the same magnitude in the same direction. So this is the vector U plus V. All right, finally, I just want to show you how to geometrically do the subtraction of vectors. So let's think about drawing U minus V using the same vectors that we've been doing. Now there are several ways you can approach this. Probably the easiest, or at least the least error-prone method, is to think of this as U plus, okay, instead of U minus V, we're going to think of it as U plus the negative of vector V. All right, this is equivalent mathematically. So what's the negative of vector V? Well, that's simply vector V with the same magnitude, but exactly the opposite direction. Okay, so I'm going to try and set that up on here. And we'll get it as close as we can to the same vector, but the opposite direction. Okay, so that's pretty close. So this is going to be negative V here. And now all we have to do is just add U and negative V, and we can do that using the same method that we just learned. And I'm going to use the triangle method, though in theory you could use either the triangle or parallelogram method. So I'm going to take negative V here and put the tail of negative V at the head of U like this. Okay, so. And then to draw U minus V or U plus negative V, we simply just connect this triangle. Okay, so that'll end up looking like this. Okay, and that's our vector U minus V.